Hello, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 3.3 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abacus. Example 3.3 is about a symmetric laminate, defined by its laminate stacking sequence, which is 45, minus 45, 0, symmetric. The laminated plate will be subjected to in-plane shell load Nx, in Newton per millimeters. We use abacus to calculate the membrane displacement U1, in the direction of the load. First, we change the work directory, so that the abacus files are organized into folders corresponding to examples in the textbook. To create the part, we select 3D deformable, shell, planar. The approximate size is used to create a grid, large enough to accommodate the dimensions that you plan to use for the part. In the sketcher, you can use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. When you are done, click the red X to exit the add utility, and done to create the part. In module property, the material properties can be entered as orthotropic, so 9 values are required to populate the stiffness matrix D. Abacus uses indicial notation with 4 subscripts, and arranges the shear components differently than the classical notation, so I have to explain that.
Okay, so I'm going to explain how do we calculate the D matrix. So Abacus needs a D matrix, which is the stiffness matrix for an orthotropic material, but we have a laminate. So how do we represent a laminate with a single D matrix, orthotropic inside the abacus, all right? So first of all, I do it with this program, which is done in Scilab. And Scilab is a free version of MATLAB, basically. It's like MATLAB, but free. So basically what you do is first you import with this exec command the ttvar, and the ttvar is a matrix that is used to coordinate transformation. It's explained in chapter 1 of the textbooks, all right? So you find the t and tvar matrix there and you'll understand. So this function, which looks complicated, but it's not because it's explained in the textbook, is here, okay? So this is a function I'm not going to explain. You just have to look it up in the textbook to understand what it does. But what it allows to do is it allows you to understand when a laminate is at 45, minus 45, whatever angle it is, it will transform coordinates to the coordinates of the laminate. All right, so I import that function, and then I start describing the laminate for this problem, all right? So I have the thickness of the lamina is 1. This is stated in the problem. The laminate is plus 45, minus 45, so symmetric. That means 6 layers. So the laminate thickness is 6 TK because there are 6 layers. Okay, after that, we have material properties. These are the properties of the lamina, the composite. They're given in the textbook. Okay, so then we create the compliance matrix for the 0-degree lamina in classical notation, which is the notation of the textbook, which is different from the notation that Abacus uses, but I'm not going to change all the literature because Abacus wants to transpose 2 columns and 2 rows. So I use classical notation, and then when I go to Abacus, I make the transformation. You'll see in a minute. Okay, so the compliance matrix is easy. This formula is here, and you can find this formula in the textbook. So in terms of lamina properties, E1 and so on, you can get the compliance. Now the stiffness is the inverse of the compliance, so that's easy. It's SP to the minus 1, that's the inverse. Now you have the stiffness, CP, of the 0-degree lamina in lamina coordinate system, which we call a prime in the textbook. That's why I put the P. CP means C prime. Okay, so now we're ready to construct the C for the entire laminate. And so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna add 2 times 0 degree. Why 2? Because if you go here, you see at the end, it says zero symmetric. Well, symmetric means that there is another 0, 0, 0, okay? So that means there are 2 laminas. So I say, okay, add two 0 degree laminas to the laminate stiffness C. And that's what I do here, all right? I put 2 times CP, but it is, I use a weight function. The weight function is TK divided by LT because really should be like this, like that, put the 2 there. So CP multiplied by 2 because there are 2 laminas, but and then the laminas are thickness TK, so that will be the thickness of the 2 laminas divided by the total. And this formula is in the textbook. So this is the averaging that we're using. So we have 2 laminas out of 6, and so we put that much of the CP into the large C. And so now we have 2 45s, yes, why? Because here we have a 45 symmetric. Right, you see here is 45 symmetric. That means there are 2 45s. Okay, so since there are 2 45s, we're gonna do this. But the 45s are not cannot be just add the CP because CP is for 0. You have to transform to the coordinate system of the laminate, the XYZ coordinate system of the laminate, and that you do with the T bar transpose. This prime is for transpose. If you know my lab, you know what I'm talking about. And so then, and then you put T bar at the end. All right, so CP is transformed to the XY coordinate system here. Then you add 2, and then the wave factor TK over LT, of course, because we are trying to average the whole thing. So you see in yellow, we have here, here, and here. So at the end, we get the total C. And no, so now add 2 minus 45s. Now I need the T bar for minus 45, which I calculate right there. And then again, I got the T bar, yes, T bar prime, CP T bar, that will rotate or transform to minus 45. And then the wave factor is I have 2 laminas of this thickness, but I got to divide by 6 because there are 6 laminas. So since I add this, then plus this, plus this, at the end I have this, and when you put it like that in Scilab, what's going to happen is that it's going to show you what the calculation is, because like MATLAB, you put the semicolon, it doesn't show you anything. If you don't put the semicolon, it will show you. So this will come out over here, and let me see, okay, here we go. And so then if I press F5, I press F5 and see here, you see here I have the C. This is the C. All right, so I have the stiffness matrix for the laminate. But then Abacus orders the rows 4, 5, 6 differently. So I had to transpose a little bit. So first thing, I make a copy. C, I make a copy into D. Then I say, oh, the D44 really is the C66. This is explained in the textbook. It's just that Abacus use different order. And then the D66 is the 44. That's it. That's the only thing. And then this D without semicolon will show us what the D is. And here we have it. You see, 3340 went over here, and 8237 went over there. All right. And okay, the numbers. These numbers are slightly different from the numbers I used when I did the video and the numbers in the textbook, because in the textbook, when I did it in the textbook, I did it with Excel, which is not so accurate, so this is better. Okay, so that's what we got. All right.
Now, we create a section to hold the section properties, including the thickness and the material to be used for the shell. Now, we assign the section to the part, that is, to the rectangle that we sketched before, which in abacus, represents the plate. Module assembly is really meant to assemble several parts into an assembly, representing a complex system or structure, but we have only one part, so we assemble that. As usual, we need a step. Next, we go into module load, to specify the boundary conditions. The plate is symmetric with respect to both, X, and Y. And it is further simply supported on the edges. Next, we apply a shell edge load on step 1, to get a tensile load Nx of 200 N per millimeter. Next, we mesh the instance, with a seat of 50. In mesh controls, we choose quad, structured. Next, create a job, and use it to run the simulation. When completed, click results. After clicking results, we are in module visualization. Von Mises stress is not applicable to composites. What we are looking for is displacement U1. Okay, that's it for today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook, by following the link in the description. Thank you.